Very good morning to you, and of course, thank you very much for joining us right here on yet another beautiful morning episode of Urban Today. Welcome from another Monday Blues kind of situation. It is the Tuesday, and you definitely know that this is the day where you get to have your productivity levels at work boosted up to 75%. That's according to the research that came through from different scientists in Germany. But moving away from that, it is a fresh week for us down here, and another fresh day. Of course, Willis is still on leave, but Nick and Tina have been holding this down, and I definitely have to turn them up on this beautiful one. Good morning to Nicholas.
Morning, 25th June. This feels like I just relocated into a new vicinity and I just bumped into a loud neighbor. Tina Fierce. Whoa, you don't get sleep. If it's not the kids yelling,
you're not that
shouting,
far away from this table. I could stand up and smack you very comfortably.
To make it worse,
Do not even go there.
This is a loud chick from morning to evening. So imagine I've just moved in. So what happens next? I have to move out.
I love you, Tina. Afford me.
Now, I tell you what.
You wouldn't afford to even live on the same house as I would live on.
No,
Don't make me get started.
The man is talking about love.
I tell you what. It has nothing to do with money, by the way.
You see, shut up. Why do you always constantly look for love?
The Bible tells me to love my
neighbor. Let love find you.
You're my neighbor. You're my neighbor, so anyway.
I'm not your neighbor.
The days of our lives. Well, sometimes I say across the country, I'll be Fort Potro and...
I say it properly. Fort Potro.
Why do you guys always cut out the Potro, though?
Ah, man, the Potro, it doesn't sound nice.
Fort Potro.
That is Tina Fierce for you. Always finding levels in my head. But anyway, she'll be fine.
Tina Fierce, how you doing?
Ah, I'm good. Someone just wanted to start off my morning in an agitated state. And I'm like, not today. Negative energy, not today. Mm. And this I want to tell to everybody out there. If somebody's trying to come into your cosmic powers, your beautiful surrounding, and they're coming with a negative vibe, tell them I'm sorry. I'm not going to catch that vibe.
Wait.
Not today.
Cosmic what, sorry?
Energies.
Oh.
What's the matter?
Around there.
Yeah, I'm just saying, for all of you who are going through a few of those, like, you know, you can walk into a space and there's someone and they just have so much negativity, they want to draw you in.
That's true.
No, just tell them, oh, sorry, Bull Pie, not today. I am walking away.
You do realize that every day we succumb to so many things that can actually tinker us off. Mm. You know, a mere entering a taxi and you bump your head on it, that's enough.
That's enough.
That's enough to just stinker you off.
Wait,
and then your
days
are
ruined. What are you doing in taxis?
I know. What the hell are you doing in a taxi?
Okay, you're wearing a cup pipe and you're going on a board and then what? That happens.
Why wear a pipe? It is a Tuesday, guys. Avoid negative energy. Avoid negative actions in case these things happen to you on such a day.
Tell them not today, Bobo. Not today. We are walking away from negative energy.
So how do you tell that bump? Not today. It's already aching.
No, that's the moment when you're like,
just don't think about it. Just let it sink in. Actually, the best thing to do right about that time is to just close your eyes and pray to God. And just be like, God, take this away. Take this cup from me. Hold the wheel.
I've encountered Mississippi's when you're in a situation and you're looking at someone who has caused it and you're like, this person is going to be the reason I go to jail.
That's
today.
Right.
Today. But you just, you know, if you don't want negativity around you, like I've said, the code word is not today.
Oh, that's great. True. Now, moving away, of course, from our motivational talk, right? I want to get into some starter this morning. Now, apparently, a school fence collapses on 8th Street children. This is some sad news that came through. Mm. And then, of course, Clive Sembusi, that is a rescue unit or police officer, has confirmed that 8th Street children were hit by a wall fence belonging to Lohana High School. Now, located along Mitiana Mulumba Road, that's, of course, in Old Kampala, just a few, that's, of course, after the former Pride Theatre, the school fence collapsed on the street children who were sleeping along its borders. Of the 8, 6 died on spot, while 2 were rushed to Mlago Hospital in a critical condition. The incident happened in the wee hours of the morning at around 2:30 a.m. It is believed that the collapse of the fence could have been due to the Sunday evening downpour that might have weakened the fence.
It was a very sad story, actually. When I did read it, I was like, my word.
And it's funny. You see how you have, because these street kids have like a network. One of them, when I watched the story I said on Book Eddie, one of them said, I had come here to have a nap, or to, you know, because they have spots where they sleep for the day or for the week. And he was told, you know, he was bullied off. And then moments later, he hears a loud noise coming down, and I'm thinking, but even then, that's not even the story. The story would be, these kids need to be given a home, because we've had cases time and again coming out, being so aggressive towards them, and then
they
recently
did,
coming out
but
with
they
these.
Did. The last time we hosted, what was her
did
name,
from
KCCA, they are working towards it. They are not even supposed to be on the streets, because someone was like, so if we were to take upon like legal action, what would the story be like? I'm like, it depends. According to the law that was passed, they are not supposed to be on the streets. So who would you sue? You can't sue the school because they're not supposed to be on the wall of the
authority,
school.
So the authority, that's in KCCA, have come out time and again, had, what, endless meetings about these kids. And even then, furthermore, came up with, was it a bill that if you found giving these kids money, that you will be jailed or fined? But I think that doesn't solve a problem. I think
it actually does. If you listen to the intricate detail of that entire bill that was passed, they do try to take these kids off the streets. But then because they now know it's not just carrying the kids and taking them off the streets and giving them a home, because when you do that, another network of kids will come. And the cycle keeps going on and on. So they are trying to curb it from the starter. For them to stop coming. I mean, you can't blame.
And not too long ago, there was a gang of kids being used to, you know, for theft.
That is what most of them are.
And you see this whole situation or conversation of the street kids on the streets is having a lot of unfolded papers, you know. So some of these things we don't get to see them on top, but
there's a lot.
KCCA is working around it. There are other NGOs that are working around it. And then I think we need to understand is that these kids we're dealing with have been on the street, so
for
you can
too
say
long.
They are streetwears. You know, so you will take them into an area like this one, keep them in, and some people feel
like
this
feel
is
like
not
home.
Comfortable. It doesn't feel like home.
It doesn't feel like what they're used to.
I was given an OMG by one of the tourists that came around, and they saw a five-year-old kid with two hands out there, and I'm thinking they should be home doing their homework, maybe just going to bedtime. But if the picture right now feels like they're comfortable where they are, but again. For a kid to be in such a status, I think it's quite sad.
It's very sad that we actually did lose the six of them. I mean, who knew what their lives would have an impact on the country. But we do hope that they rest in eternal peace. And the two that were rushed to Mulago, we hope that they get back to their feet as soon as possible. Now, moving away from that, of course, we want to get into some shout-outs this morning. And my shout-out is going on to the entire police force. What have they done this time around? Have you been fined a penalty of over-speeding or even having a car that is in a very poor mechanical condition and you did not live up to paying this fine? Now, I had that news for you. Now, apparently, the police has introduced an electronic express penalty system known as the EPS that will be used to track drivers who default on payment of fines that are issued to them by police officers under the express penalty system. Now, Mr. Stephen Kasima, that is, of course, the director of traffic, says the automated EPS will reduce the number of drivers who dodge the payment of penalties. Now, he also says that using the system, defaulters will be tracked because all driving permits and vehicle number plates are captured within the system. The EPS, according to Mr. Kasima, says that it runs on a portable electronic machines and printers will replace receipt books. He also says that some drivers have unpaid penalties over more than 5 million Ugandan shillings, adding that it will no longer be the case. That is, of course, after the automated system has been put into operation and they are trying to dodge the payment of penalties and fines. He also says that the system has functions to identify offenders, track vehicles and pending penalties read by the vehicle number plates and the driving permit details.
But you see, I mean, with the number of taxes in this country, it's so easy to run away from, you know, this charge. And you find
why are you people complaining?
And you find that one taxi can share a plate number with three others. You know?
Did you see that photo that went viral? There was a government car that had the same license plate as a regular car. URA, what's up? What's up
with that? And this should stop. It calls for, I think, even us as the public, to say, I've seen that plate number somewhere. And you see, it could be your own car, by the way. Here you are saying, sharing a number plate with a car that has so many charges on it. Could be theft, could even be this.
I have a friend who bought a car that was actually stolen and he had no clue. He's chilling at home on a Sunday morning and there's a full-on raid at his place. He's in his heights. He's like, what? It's like, I just bought my baby.
And you don't answer the questions at your home. They take you in and you answer them later.
Yeah.
And there's actually going to be a penalty in case one is gotten for not clearing their fines. It's going to be a penalty
there should be.
$200,000 in Ghanaian shillings. And reports also came through that about 8 billion Ugandan shillings was collected by the police over this kind of fines last year.
So let me
ask, where did it go?
Yes.
It is doing police work.
It is?
Yeah, in terms of their fuel.
You know, in Uganda nowadays, you have to be clear when they give you when they give you a specific amount that came from a particular authority, you're like, where is it?
I mean, recently when they were reading the budget, they gave us a section of accountability and it seems to have lots of money. So we do
hope for starters, I think it should go to revamping their police stations. They look horrible.
The posts or the stations themselves?
The posts, the stations, the homes,
you're
not.
You walk into CPS and what welcomes you is a scent of urine. You're like, oof.
I am going to do time. But anyway, let's move on with these shout outs. This shout out in particular, I am pumped. I am psyched. Finally, I believe justice is going to be served.
Yes.
Now, the High Court, that is, of course, Judge Flavia Anglin Senoga, has found guilty Pine Carbon proprietor Muhammad Sebufu of murdering businesswoman Betty Donna Katshabe over a 9 million car debt in October 2015. He has been convicted. He has been convicted with seven others, while Ewan Ulwanga Stephen, a special hire driver, has been found guilty of being an accessory after commission of an offense. Justice Senoga has ruled that that prosecution has proved beyond reasonable doubt that Sebufu and seven others had a common intention to kidnap Katshabe from her home in Bwebaja, robbed her of her mobile phone, and tortured her to death. Now, Sebufu and his co-accused have therefore been found guilty and consequently convicted of murder, kidnap, and robbery. The judge has explained that prosecution evidence placed the convicts at the scene of the crime are those who kidnapped Donna and intentionally caused her death. Death to them all too! Ah!
Tina.
No, seriously. Yeah. Seriously. Y'all may think I'm being... Let me tell you,
when this story
first came out, I was like, wait, in this here, in my country, this is, ooh, this one should not even be taken to jail. Abby, they should bring this one to City Square. Let them bring him to City Square and let us do our best.
I know.
It's funny, by the way.
I'm not calling for mob justice.
They picked up the late Betty, and these guys came through. They actually asked, are you Betty? And she says, yes, I'm Betty. And she was taken away. She was drugged until, I think, Pine. I think Pine. Is it Pine? And then that's where the whole thing happened. And I'm thinking, everyone watched.
You had
over 30
exactly.
people watching this person being killed.
Being bitten.
And I'm thinking,
to death.
Do you remember the scenario?
It's different
of the,
being bitten to an inch of your life.
Who came in a taxi and then beat up, caught some guy, brought a light. And for
I
a split
know.
Sec, I thought it was a movie.
But it was real.
But it was real. I
mean, there was also an instance down here at Logogo when someone you know, was just gotten from the car park, put into another car, and you know, they drove off.
But moving forward, I was hearing the solicitor from how they call them? The accused.
He's
like, oh, there's not enough evidence of actually pinning these guys down. We shall actually go and appeal them.
Imagine let every Ugandan citizen who is passing by pinch you.
We cannot do that. That's for taking the law in our hands. That's why we do have
mob
justice.
Mob justice is very deadly.
That's mob justice.
Anyway,
it's against the law.
The family are still grieving over the death of Betty.
I mean, let me tell you why this story pissed me off. Is that yes? She had a nine million debt, but here's the fun bit: she had given them a check and told them, "You know, check a mature ringer on this date at this time." It's not like he had agreed and taken the check too.
Of course, he wouldn't leave the check behind.
So why would you come for her before the time of the check has come? That's being malicious, muchite.
I think the intentions here were to deal with...
July is the day when, of course, the sentence will be passed. And if it's going to be life imprisonment or if it's going
to
be...
This guy does not deserve to even sit back and regret and rethink his life. Let him die.
If the judicial is to give that woman a job that side, would we survive the criminals?
Oh, the death penalty would be so alive.
Well, my shout out goes to Kampala Central Lions Club. The Lions Club of Kampala Central did come out to install a new president in Frank Muramura as its 24th president to lead the club for the Lionistic year 2019-2020, effective 1st July 2019. Furthermore, Muramura takes the mentor from the Lion, Israel Manzi, who was given a district award. It was presented by the district governor as the president of the Lionistic year 2018-2019, beating 32 other club presidents to this particular award. And in a statement that was, of course, put out
out there, Mads' extension program that saw the club sponsoring two new clubs into the district is one of the many efforts that catapulted. Okay, thank you very much, Tina.
Welcome.
Moving forward, the installation took place during a colorful event held at the Silver Springs Hotel in Bogorobi on June 14, 2019. In his first speech, Muramura pledged to rally the club members towards a common goal to serve selflessly to the community in areas that the Lions Club focuses on, such as diabetes awareness campaigns, vision care, hunger alleviation, environment conservation, and fighting childhood cancer. This sounds like a man who's willing to do his work, and hopefully does it quite well in his town. But thumbs up to the Kampala Central Clubs line. I think these Rotary clubs have done quite well for the society. Moving forward, you know what needs to be done to have more across the country, because I feel like they're more centralized.
More clubs?
Yeah.
There's clubs everywhere.
Everywhere.
Yeah, the clubs, but I think it goes back to, you know, how they handle them and how they run their business.
Are they political though?
No. They're not political. It's just a bunch of
communal.
Very rich people.
It's like, you know, Rotary clubs, you know. The kind of things.
Okay.
But anyway, moving away from that, of course, we do wish nothing but the best to the new president of the Kampala Central Lions Club down here in Kampala. And we'll be waiting to see what kind of, you know, landmark that he gets to leave behind. Now, moving away from that, being a Tuesday, beautiful morning, we want to take a quick look at what is making headlines in the news dailies. Let's take a quick look at, of course, the new vision they're talking about. Pato, who was charged with another woman kidnap. We all remember Pato, the man that, of course, has been on a lockdown from SA after he had been, you know, phoned, you know, with connections regarding Susan Magara's death. Now, apparently, there is another woman in the picture. Details on page 5, President Yoweri Museveni, down in China. You get to have most of those details and, of course, what he was doing there on page 3 of the new vision. 1,400 schools that topped university admissions, as, of course, details on page 4, 29 up to 32. How digital express penalty affects motorists, so get yourself a copy and get to catch up with this one. A good initiative coming in from the police right there. And looking into more news coming in, they say that police have arrested Nakawa Panga gang suspects. For the people that have been living in Nakawa, you've heard about these you know, kind of gang attacks. So the new vision brings you most of those details regarding their arrest. Why Sebufu was convicted? More details coming in right here in today's copy of the new vision. More teachers charged with exam malpractice. That's a sad one. But of course, the new vision is giving you details. Her vision is also making headlines. And of course, not forgetting some sports news coming in right here. They're talking about Cranes, who must deal with Billiant. That's, of course, coming in the next game right there. Apparently, the Uganda Cranes is leading the table, for those of you who didn't know. Mm. And then, of course, some more news coming in regarding the AFCON and some international scene regarding some sports. For you, at only 2,000 Ugandan shillings, you get yourself a hard copy. At only 1,000 Ugandan shillings, you get the soft copy courtesy of the Vision app.
Well, in the Daily Monitor on this fine day, Tuesday, June 25th, there is a lot in regards to the conviction of the 7 guilty who tortured a woman to death. Evidence that pinned the pined car bond killers. That is Daily Monitor's headline on this day. And furthermore, they also talk about the new traffic penalty system targeting defaulters or defaulting drivers. That's on page 2. KCC delayed to okay the demolition of the collapsed a wall that took away 6 lives. And that you can find out in the Daily Monitor. Bravo Uganda Cranes. Still so much conversation in regards to the Uganda Cranes, of course, who came out on top just the other day with a 2-0 victory against DR Congo. Something on banking growth in Asian banking segments, deepening financial inclusion. And also for the kids, there is an outlet right there for you on page number 35. Furthermore, something on the governor of Bank of Uganda, Mutebile. Looks like they want him out of this job, and they say that he is the root cause of the current status with the Bank of Uganda. Unlocking the value of of the value in that is Banker Assurance. You can find more of that story in the Daily Monitor. Of course, in the sports section, they have something on the Rugby Cranes, who got the job done against the Kenya Simbas. And also coming through on the back page, still on the Uganda Cranes, Azira Aucho bring much needed calm. And that is something you can look into as far as the Daily Monitor for today gets to go.
Bakugamba Mufti Menk, ebintu kumi na chimu byalekedde abasiraamu ab'ebijambi abalumbi omugagga ne batta mukazi we obujulizi obumeze sebufu ebibonero ebikakali byayolekedde. Yes. Engere famire y'omukazi gwe yatta jewanye okuwangula, and of course if you turn inside, it's a very beautiful thing. I'm seeing a photo here. Annette Kobusingye wakati eyali lawyer wakatushabe n'abooluganda nga bajaganya wabweru mu kkooti. Evans Ochengi nga akaba abantu babadde wano biri omwo mu bukedde byonna mu banoonya nawo obwanja olieyo ng'onoonya. Waliwo omusajja wanagamba ye anoonya mukyala akola, waliwo omukyala wanagamba anoonya omwami omwetegefu okuwasa. Kwegamba n'ebyo biri omwo mu bukedde yammwe muligo Oluganda, nze lwannemye ngezaako bisomanga widisi naye biganye. Stella Nyanzi alagiddwa okwewozaako tannaba kwogera kintu kyonna, ebyo byonna biri mu bukedde wa leero. Cranes terina mulwadde.
Like no injuries.
No injuries.
Terina no.
Terina.
Oh wow. What meanwhile, in the Crane situation, did y'all see? Apparently, Pastor Mbonye prophesied we are going to win. Ah. Wait! We are going to win the AFCON, but in penalties.
I was like,
this man. Linda go ask.
Mbonye
like, this man's receding hairline is going with his life.
But let me ask you something. What if we actually win through
the
penalties?
Oh boy, bye.
Please, let me ask.
No, let's just make
you know what? Let me drink tea. No,
all right, tell Nicholas. Me what. What if? Okay, let me try and answer that question. What if? Let's say.
Don't use the football facts. Because clearly we're dealing
with
the
football. We're dealing with Mbonye.
Clearly, I can't use comedy because this is not comedy.
This is comedy, one man.
But Mbonye is.
Okay. Is it what? Is it what?
Comedy.
Who said it's comedy? Is someone's papa?
If the word.
I mean, people be kissing this man's feet now.
Oh, by the way, yeah, that's true.
He can. By the way, Mbonye. Just so you know, I was made in the image of the Lord. Please come kiss my feet.
So when did he make this prediction? Or
why? I think it was
sometime
yesterday.
Well, they call him prophecy. Yes. Mm. It's called prophecy. I don't know when he made it, but I
think it was like yesterday.
So what? He wakes like up from this.
Have you ever seen someone say something so stupid and like...
You guys have not even answered my question. You've not even tried to attempt to answer it.
Abi, if they
I can't even do. I
if
mean,
it happens like that...
Through penalties.
I am leaving Catholicism. I am joining Zoe Ministries. I could be that on my life.
Hey.
Okay. All Nicholas, right. Full stop. How about you?
You're here. Let's even shake on it. Let's shake on it.
I would love to believe so. Like, wake up one morning and then read the front pages. Even without even looking at the internet, Uganda Cranes champions of Africa. Like, I would picture that on so many levels. Like, that would be like something really nice, by the way, to go on and feed on for the rest of the how many years. But if that were to come true, thanks to this guy's prophecy, I think we'd all be like, okay, this guy is the next big thing in
religion. Swear, if it comes to pass. Mbavumye nyo, mkoyo mbavuma, kanzijembe egateko mbatuvume fena, if it happens.
What teams do you think could give, you know, Uganda Cranes a very hard time?
Zimbabwe.
Zimbabwe? There is Egypt, really? The West African sides in Nigeria. I mean, they're your suspects. But unless...
I was beaten.
By whom?
Who? What's the name?
In other news, by the way, I charges to get 25% of our condolences. Wafuna mufu, ngabe asaya mucha che, we're gonna funa 25% of what amabogo.
Abasabile wa Mbonye.
Bofa.
Bofa. Eh, ne wawe des katukame msabe ni His Excellency awarded yo say 50 million of mabogo towards your death. They get 25% of it. 25%.
And it goes well.
It depends. Bonagebe, whatever source the mabogo comes from.
Okay, amabogo we baka jawe ni kagenda. Are they setting a place for you in your afterlife?
Auntie, like, it's going to the church.
I'm asking, no, is that your prayers? No, is that your prayers that are taking you into the afterlife, the next life? Is that you booking a ticket to heaven? What the hell?
It's more like saying that, no, yo, thanks for dying, but this is what we're getting from you. But anyway.
I get it. But where is it going? It better book me a place.
And by the time I get to St.
Peter's,
by the time I get to St. Peter's at that gate, I'm like, so you got my reservation? It's like an RSVP.
You can't, there's no...
St. Peter's for someone who dropped the Bible.
I dropped the Bible, by the way, and St. Peter understands. I think God looks at me and is like, my daughter, I understand. They have ruined that. They have ruined
she's
it.
She's an imagination.
Nah, God loves me. You better tell yourself that every day.
There was like a GIF where this guy go to heaven and found a few names. I'm not going to mention the names. They're like, no. See, like, I see what? See heaven, you want. Now, who are you done? Now, come out.
Let us go in for a very quick break, but when we do get back, it will be Kachai, and this time around we're talking about love, marriage, and everything that comes with it, but on the Islamic perspective. We'll see you right after this.